Dr. Elizabeth Hoefer wants you to get your head on straight. In a world gone sideways, having balance and integrity in all areas of life leads to having confidence that breeds clarity. Clarity is essential to living an authentic life, and all the information shared on the Get Your Head On Straight podcast is designed to inspire you to live your life fulfilled. Enjoy the show.
Welcome to Get Your Head On Straight with Dr. Elizabeth Hoefer. I am so excited about my guest. He's been somebody that I've wanted to interview on my show for several years. His story of healing is dramatic and very encouraging. So I want everybody to be excited to hear from Ali today.
Hi. Hi, everybody.
Hey. So how are you?
I'm doing fantastic. How are you?
I'm really, really good. It's been a little bit since I've had the pleasure of taking care of you because you went and moved away, but I wanted everybody to hear your story because how we met and what happened and how much has changed for you in the last several years has been truly remarkable. So I always ask this to my guests when I ask them about their healing process with Blair Chiropractic. I always ask them, how did we get well connected?
How do we get well connected? Well, I was dying of a herniated disc and I was in tears. That's how we got connected originally.
Yeah.
Originally. So I was training mixed martial arts. I was fighting professionally. Unfortunately, that career didn't go very far. But regardless, I was training and I had hurt my back pretty badly. And for almost, I think, 3 or 4 days, I can't recall exactly the amount of days because I wasn't sleeping because I was in so much pain. I could not sleep on my back. I could not sleep on my side. I could not stand. I could not sit. I could not do anything except put a pile of blankets and pillows in like a cone shape on the floor and lay with my belly down on top of that. That was the only sort of relief I got, or if I was submerged in water. So luckily I had a friend that had a jacuzzi at their apartment complex and I was using that a little too much, but
right.
That was the only time I would get any sort of relief. And luckily we found you and you were available that day to help me out.
Yeah.
And it was like, after we tried to contact several other people and they couldn't do it anyways. So I remember you were trying to do the initial questionnaire exam that you
yes.
do. And I couldn't answer the question because I was in so much pain. I was crying and I was trying to hold back to be a tough guy. And you're like, okay, screw this. Just get on the table.
Yeah. I remember, and typically the way that it works when people come in to see me, I do like a really thorough, in-depth health history and kind of understand like where you've been, what traumas have you had. Well, it was obvious that you were in the midst of having an attack. You literally like crawled into the office. You didn't walk in, you crawled in, and it was definitely like an emergent situation. And I said, listen, you couldn't even sit down to sit in the x-ray chair to get images.
That's right.
So I had to lay you on your back and do this really wild, like low back traction adjustment on you to even get you to the point where we could take x-rays of your neck.
Yeah. And I still don't know what you did. It went click, click. And you had like, I felt like you had the top of my hip with your fingers. And then I remember it got click, click. You're like, did you feel that? And I was like, yeah. You're like, okay, you can stand now. And it was the first time I did it. It was like a Jesus moment, man. I was like, whoa. And then I literally stood up straight because I was a candy cane. So if people at home could watch this, I was literally like that. And I'm not even exaggerating.
Right.
It was like this. And then you did that and I could like stand up straight without excruciating pain. I mean, it was still painful because my disc was still herniated.
Absolutely.
Like I went from freaking 0 to 100. Like I could not believe it. I was like, oh my God.
It was pretty miraculous. Yeah. I was like, you can stand. And then you like walked over and you sat there. And then we did the Blair upper cervical correction. And literally within like 2 weeks, you were completely pain free.
And I think that was 5 years ago. 5 years later, I'm still okay.
Yeah. You haven't had another Blair adjustment.
Nope. Never.
And you continued to train. So we got well connected because you came in an emergent situation. You got your first Blair correction 5 years ago. What's been different about your life since your Blair correction? What have you been able to do, experience that you hadn't done before?
I think that I'm 35 now. So I think the biggest thing is I'm 35 years old and I can still compete with 20-year-olds on steroids. I mean, and that's just the truth of the matter. Like, I beat up 20-year-olds on steroids still, and I'm 35 and supposed to be, like, out of my prime. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
At that time when I met you, I thought it was, like, I didn't know if I was – and this is, sounds like I'm exaggerating, but I wasn't, because the level of pain, and for 3 days straight, I didn't sleep. I literally thought that was, like, oh, my God, this is going to be my life.
Yeah.
Like, this is it. Like, I literally – destroyed my body enough to where it just gave up. Like, it can't go back anymore. What am I going to do with myself?
Mm-hmm.
You know? So that moment, that was the one injury. I've torn everything. I've torn everything from your shoulders to your knees to I've torn the cartilage in between my ribs. I've done everything under the sun. Anybody that could ever get an injury, I've probably gotten it. That was the one injury that actually put me in fear. Like, this is the end of the road. What am I supposed to do? And my whole life at that point has been, I use my body for making money, you know, whether it was training, martial arts training or personal training. That was how I made my living. That's how I ate. So that was like a huge fear factor moment.
Mm-hmm.
And I really didn't, I was like, I'm hitting like a fork in the road and I have no idea where I'm going to go next. And luckily you were there to get me out of it, and you made it seem so like effortless.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it was a pretty divine appointment for sure. And it was neat to see how everything kind of came to pass. And then to know 5 years later, all of the amazing things that you've done. At one point, you even had this amazing gym where you were training, you know, mixed martial arts and teaching kids like how to do it properly. You were working with Parkinson's patients, and you would invite me to come over and just talk to them and like help them understand, hey, you can have a different story. You don't have to continue to degenerate. And it was so awesome to be able to come in and do those little talks and educate people on their health and let them know that just because they are this way now doesn't mean they have to stay that way.
Yes. And most importantly, how important the spinal cord is and how it can actually heal. The body heals itself when it's aligned.
Amen.
And I was like, with the Parkinson's people, I try to tell them that, but I couldn't tell it as well as you said it. But I was like, listen, if your spine is aligned, there's going to be a lot of, I'm not saying it's going to cure Parkinson's, but there's going to be some issues that you have now that will actually lessen, if not go away, you know, with just making sure at least we have your spine corrected and it's mm-hmm. straight and your all your knickknacks are zapping the right way.
I love it, the knickknacks. Well, it's so interesting because even in this last couple of years, I've taken on another educational platform. I'm getting my diplomate in cranial cervical junction procedures. And
I'm super complicated.
Right? But it's so rewarding because it really helps me be able to even deeper educate and understand the neurology and how the brain and the spinal cord work and how the traumas affect it and what happens in your brain with cerebral spinal fluid and all of the things and implications like Parkinson's and Alzheimer's and MS and all that stuff. Like, I feel more confident now more than ever being able to tie the neurology to your atlas and confidently give a correction that I know will make a massive difference in the physiology and the function. So it's been fun to be able to do that, learn that, and continue to talk with people like you who are like the oldies but goodies, right? Like, I was young
yeah,
in my
the
career.
Originals.
Yeah, you're the OG.
Yeah, I'm the OG. I mean, you were saving people then, so I can only imagine with all the newfound education, what you're doing now. It's probably remarkable.
It's really fun. So what would you tell a skeptic? Because I know that you talk to people that like with Parkinson's and they have, you know, these issues and they're obviously already seeking care with like what you were doing, but there are a lot of people who are just like, eh, I'm not sure.
Yeah. I think they're silly. So I have another good friend of mine who's a very good chiropractor in San Francisco as well. And he's in, just like you, has saved like tons of people. And I think the biggest thing is it's not, some people think it's just about fixing like a skeletal issue, but I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, but chiropractic work, especially flare chiropractic work, it defines like a lot of, it could cure a lot of different things.
Mm-hmm.
Like if you got a cold, go get adjusted. I'm serious. If you got depression, go try getting adjusted because it can help. I think a lot of issues that human beings have go, it start from the fact that their spinal cord's not intact.
Yeah.
It's like off and your central nervous system is not firing the way it's supposed to. And things are clogged or things are not sparking the way they're supposed to. And you need to get that lined up so that those things can start telling each other what to do correctly. So, but correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that was it, right?
Let me tell you something. You just like gave the best layman's definition of chiropractic. Like, it's true. All those lines have to line up. And I mean, I am a Blair chiropractor, not because I ever had like a neck pain or a backache or a headache. It was because I had depression, anxiety, and suicidal thoughts. And I was healed because of a Blair correction. And I knew that I had to spend the rest of my life doing it, teaching it, and giving hope back to people who didn't have hope, because that was my story. So absolutely, I couldn't agree more. I mean, every bit of your life and the way that you filter your life is through your nervous system. And if it's not intact, you're not going to have a good time.
The first thing that's actually produced in womb, right?
Yeah.
When a baby is kid, the central nervous system is the first thing that develops, if I'm not mistaken.
How do you know these things? Did I educate you that well?
Well, you did too, but yes, I'm very smart.
So, I love that.
It's true though. So my friend who's up in San Francisco, he's amazing. And he reminds me a lot of you because he just helps tons of people. And
yeah.
He always used to tell me, you got the flu? Just come in, I'll cure it. And I'm telling you, like, there was a lot of people that because of this dude, and I'm of course, because of you too.
Oh yeah, no.
The common flu. They would go to him, they adjusted in 2 days, they'd be like, I'm feeling better.
Yeah.
So, well, okay, you call it coincidence, but after
it's literally not coincidence. I mean, chiropractors can't truly say we cure anything. I tell people, I move the bone and God does the healing.
Nice. There you
and
go.
He gave us this ability. He gave us this innate intelligence to have our bodies be able to heal when they're properly aligned. And I always say this, structure dictates function. So if you're structurally intact and your bones line up and they protect this thing called the nervous system, that's what drives your immune system. That's what drives your cardiovascular system. That's what drives your digestive system. All of it's connected from your brain, your spinal cord, your nerves. So it goes hand in hand. And so the fact that you truly get that is, it's wonderful. And there needs to be 8 billion people who think like you.
Well, I hope I've spoken enough caveman talk that they would understand it.
I think like, so.
It's just common sense. If you would think about it, it's called the central nervous system.
Correct.
It's the center of all everything. It makes everything run, you know?
Yeah, you know, but common sense, that's something that escapes.
Man, Thomas Paine wrote about it a long time ago. You should read that book again.
Come on. You're awesome. So I have one more question for you. And it's something that I like to ask kind of to like end this official interview, but I think that you'll be able to speak to it well. I like to ask people, what does it look like for you to live your life in alignment?
Okay. Well, like real bright. I mean, because there's certain people that have had that my entry that really understand what I'm talking about. And it's a very scary ordeal. It's like when your back goes out, it's like a very frightening situation. And there's a lot of people I know who have serious back injuries and they've never even thought about going to a chiropractor. And if there's any doctors out there, I'm sorry, but it's the truth because doctors mislead people a lot. Mm-hmm. Like they go, no, that's not real medicine. It's like, first off, you're not anybody to say if something is a real medicine or not. So stop talking. It's a matter of if the person gets healed or gets better. Or not,
yeah. You know? What's best for the patient?
Yeah. If it's an old voodoo lady in Miami, Florida, but she's making people better, I'm going to call that medicine because you're making people better.
Yeah.
Right? That's what it's about, making people healthy.
Yeah.
And I think that like if people went through what I experienced and met somebody like you and got better as quick as I did, it's like you go from like a really dark tunnel when you're in a train and it just does that.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, oh, there's the end of the tunnel. I can go out of it now. That's probably the way I would put it.
Wow. That's powerful.
Thanks. That's the way I would put it. That's honestly how I envision that.
That is so powerful. And nobody's ever explained it like that before. So I really like that.
Oh, good.
Now that you're out of that dark tunnel and you are in the light, in the brightness, what are you able to do now?
Everything. I mean, everything. Like I'm 35 years old and I still continue to practice a sport in an art form that is so hard on your body that puts you in so many different awkward positions. A man my size, I'm 6'1", I'm 240 pounds and I could, you know, I could stick my knees behind my head and touch the floor. You know, I mean, that's, my spine is working in ways that a man my size probably shouldn't, you know? Mm-hmm. And I'm doing it with, again, steroided out 20-year-olds. So, and they're, you know, trying to throw me around. They, you know, I'm not just keeping up with them. I'm beating them up.
Right on. That's awesome.
My body's stronger than, you know, most of them. So that's what it is. And I'm all natural. You know, I just eat my veggies.
That's good.
I eat my veggies and I got Blair Chiropractic work and that did it for me.
That's it. So, that's all you need.
That's it. You know, I can do things that most 35-year-olds probably couldn't do with their bodies or are too afraid to do, but I have confidence in it. And maybe also I have confidence and I know an avenue where I could always heal too.
That's true.
You, right?
Knowing where you can go to get help is so key. And, you know, I have people that literally move all over the world and they come back when they need help because they know where they can come get help. And that's so rewarding to know that, like, the story that I went through to get to where I am, to be able to provide this care was worth it, right? Like, I wouldn't have appreciated the healing that I got if I hadn't suffered as much as I suffered.
Sure. Yeah.
And so I'm so passionate about, like, being available and providing this care that, you know, people 6 years later can call me up and say, you still have the same number. I need to come get checked. I'm like, let's get you checked. Let's see what's going on.
It's the best. It's great to have somebody like you around.
For you know? Sure.
Yeah, you got our back. So
literally,
what we do to ourselves. Yeah, literally. No matter what we do to ourselves, we can always give you a call and, yeah, go get fixed up.
It's good stuff.
Yeah.
Well, this has been a fun conversation. It's been good to catch up with you and to remember that powerful moment in time. And I can't believe it's already been like 5 years. That's wild.
Yeah, 2015.
And it's like one upper cervical adjustment. That was it. And you're healed. So,
and I came back to you several, so people don't think I just like ran off. I went back several times after to make sure that I was still adjusted, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. The only reason I haven't seen you recently is because you moved away, but it's not because you weren't consistent with your care up until you moved. And the truth is, when you need it, you'll just come back to Orange County and we'll get you fixed up.
Definitely, no matter where I am in the world.
Amen. COVID be damned. You will get on a plane and fly here.
Sure will.
I love it. Well, hey, thank you so much for sharing your story. I know that somebody listening is going to be inspired by the fact that they found hope through your testimony with healing your disc herniation, your low back pain, and the debilitating suffering that you were going through back then. And we're so thankful that we crossed paths. I'm so thankful that we crossed paths and got to be a part of that incredible story for you.
Me too. And thank you for having me.
Absolutely. All right, everybody. Thanks for tuning in to Get Your Head On Straight with Dr. Elizabeth Hoefer. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please do not hesitate to reach out to me at wellconnectedchiro.com. And of course, if you want to know more about the Blair technique, please, please look me up. Until next time, take care.
Thank you for listening to Get Your Head On Straight with Dr. Elizabeth Hoefer. Visit wellconnectedchiro.com for more details from the show blog post and to learn what Blair Upper Cervical Chiropractic can do for you. To learn more about Dr. Hoefer and her practice, you can find her at Well Connected Chiropractic in Mission Viejo, California by visiting wellconnectedchiro.com for more information.